Today, we are going to make some grass. No, I'm not in Colorado, so it's not going to be that kind of grass. It's our techniques that are so simple and sensible, your mowers have practically built themselves.
Hello, folks. It's Mad Dog Merv, and welcome to today's show. I think I want to go wabbit hunting or some kind of hunting, but to do so, I'm going to need a truck. And well, what's better than a great big Chevy that's way up in the air with like, camo or something like that. Actually, I think we're going to do the GMC that we reviewed a few weeks ago. So let's get going on this build of the GMC pickup truck.
We reviewed this Revell kit a few weeks ago, and I really like the simplicity of it. Some of the components that I don't have to build, because I'm not a big builder. I prefer the finishing of models. So we'll see how this goes. I'm kind of excited to do this big game country pickup. Now the whole reason I got it, remember, is I wanted to look at a camouflage pattern for my Blazer, because I was thinking of doing my Blazer in a camo pattern like this. And when I saw this model kit, I thought, oh yeah, we're gonna try it out and just take a look and see how it moves us. So we're gonna do kind of a modern woodland camouflage with a black olive drab and a kind of a tannish brown color. So we're gonna start out with this Rust-Oleum. It's a camouflage color, one in their camouflage series that I have. Not sure why exactly I have it, but I have it. Hey, how about that? And it's called Deep Forest Green. So I think it'll work good for the kind of a olive green color. I don't know. I've never used it before, so let's check it out. So we shake it up and we shoot it on here, and hey, I like it. I think it's going to be a good base color. First time trying this paint out. And yeah, definitely like it. I think it covered pretty good. Definitely want to warm your can before you spray. And here's the cab. I just gave it a light polish with 4000 grit to just kind of make sure that I didn't have anything rough on there. And you can kind of see how it looks there. Now, before I decal it, I'm going to have to put something on there for the decals to really adhere to, or I'm going to get a lot of silvering. So I use the Pledge Floor Care that we've talked about before, and I just put a layer. Actually, I brushed a layer on the entire cab and sides, and you can kind of see the sheen that it's got. So I start my decals with the very front corner here to kind of match up the wheel well and match up the fender. I want to make sure I match everything just perfect. And here on the other side, you can see we've got the one on the door. We've got the marker light that we've put in. Again, just want everything to match up just right so that as we put the ones on the hood and on the top and all these other places, that they match up just right. So that's what we did. And you can see how the pattern turned out. I think it is pretty good. I did use a lot of decal solvent though, because these decals, well, they just did not want to snug down into the doors and some of the other places. So as you can see, after using some decal solvent, we were able to get it down in the cracks here of the doors. There was some bubbles in some other areas that we were able to get rid of with the decal solvent. And here is the bed and how it turned out. Speaking of the tailgate, it didn't fit worth a dang. This the weakest part of the kit right there. I opted to keep the inside of the bed this forest green. Just thought it would be fitting. So on the chrome parts, I went ahead and I took some of the dull coat lacquer and I mixed it with a little bit of gloss coat lacquer, about a 2-to-1 mixture with a little bit of lacquer thinner, and I sprayed all the chrome down to dull the chrome. I didn't want this bright shiny chrome on this truck. And then I sprayed some black on the grill. Now for the frame, I had kind of a steel color and I decided to it's a spray paint, and I went ahead and sprayed the entire thing. It did kind of sputter in some places, and it gave me that kind of a look, like it had an undercoating on it. So I went with it. Of course, need to paint the exhaust, and I'm going to paint the frame itself black. But the rest of it, it's okay. It'll work. Went ahead and got the shocks painted a beautiful yellow, and some of the other components, as you can see here, we've kind of got them pre-painted. The engine I wound up painting just kind of a blue-gray by Testers. Now for the interior, I had this kind of a beige color. I can't remember the name of it, but it's an extra color, an old extra color. Mixed it up with a little lacquer thinner and fired away. I really like this tan color. It looks very similar to the tan that was used on the Chevys and GMCs in the late 70s. Now you can see this has a spare tire there in the back. And as I was looking through the instructions, I couldn't find a place to mount it, and I thought, oh, this is just kind of a pathetic little thing. You can see I painted it this same interior color, at least for the cover, and went ahead and sanded it down, and then decided, you know what, I'm going to keep this for a different project. This truck's not getting a spare tire. Okay, so on the interior, it turned out pretty good. It's got this little bit of a sheen to it, so I really like it. However, I took some of Larry's bath water and I went down the lines and toned down the carpet just a little bit. And I decided, well, I didn't want to have this four on the tree or three on the tree or whatever it was. I wanted to have a stick shift on the floor. So I got one out of a Chrysler product and stuck it in there and took the one off of the column here. You can see how I just painted some black. The decals went on very nicely for the instruments, and easy peasy lemon squeezy, we have a pretty decent looking dashboard and a pretty good representation of what the GMC dashboard looked like back then. I should know, my father-in-law had one with this tan color. It was a 78. So yeah, I think it turned out pretty good. We've got the CB radio mounted under the dash here, just like a good old 70s/80s truck should have. Now you can see the size of the tire here compared to some of the other kit tires that are out there, like the Desert Dogs, which are really nice. But these are big and they're mean. I love them. And guess what? I did resin cast them because I'm going to want them on another project for sure. So the truck assembly went together nice and quick, a few little details to paint, and poof, here is the finished product. You can see I've blacked out around the window. I put that GMC banner across the front of the windshield. You've got the blacked out mirrors, and you've got the nice yellow shocks that are installed in there. I had to extend the pins just a little bit so everything would fit and line up well. But I've blacked out the rail on the side of the bed as well as the roll bar.
All right, folks, sounds like I gotta oil up the turntable here. But here is our final result. You can see them big, wonderful tires on there. We've blacked out most of the grill, although the kind of the main parts are still aluminum. We shaded down the chrome because we didn't want real bright chrome, so I dulled it out just a little bit. Blacked out some, like the roll bar, the mirrors, you know, things like that, but left the door handles chrome. I left the step chrome, the bumpers chrome, and the wheels chrome in this case. So just kind of my own personal touch. And I got this figure of John Cena. I think he's a little bit small, more like about 1/27th, 1/28th scale. But you know what? It just makes this truck look cooler and bigger. We'll zoom in here a little bit on those rifles so you can see those. And we got a little bit of debris up on the truck. I got to finish putting some mud on it. We'll get that mud on here in the next few days, but I wanted to show it to you folks the way it is right now.